Hello friends, welcome to our channel. Friends, I will show you the sixth sample video for CellPip fourth section, that is listening to a news item. If you want to see all of the CellPip tutorials, then you can search on YouTube by writing CellPip Store. You will find all the other tutorial series here. Listening part is having 6 practice tests and 1 practice task as well. Total time allocated with the listening section is 50 minutes. Please keep in mind that passage will be played only once in the actual CellPip test. Now, let's start with CellPip fourth section, that is listening to a news item task. In this task you will listen to a small conversation and will have total 5 questions. You will find options in this task in the form of drop-down, and you need to choose the most appropriate option from the options given in the drop-down. Let's take an example now. Please listen to the audio carefully.
21 survivors of brutal forestry settlement by the Canadian government recently gathered in Aviat, Nunavut, for a formal apology. Maurice Anthony, 81, was there. She was a young girl in spring 1950 when police arrived with government workers to uproot her and other Aiawamiat Inuit from their camps at Inadi Lake, in Nunavut's rugged interior region, inland of Hudson Bay. Anthony has kept her story out of the public eye until now. She said she was waiting all these years for an apology outlining the details of what had been done to her and her family, so no one could call her a liar. Anthony spoke in Inuktitut to CBC journalist Jordan Koenig in January, where we were in the first place. That is Inadi Lake. We had everything we needed, Anthony said. There were no stores, there were no preachers, there were no nurses. There was no hamlet, there was no bylaw. But because of elders and the adults, we lived a good life by their teaching us how to survive. The hermit lived off the land by hunting and fishing, following a nomadic existence in tune with the seasons. We had no clue what was coming to us, and that time, we had no clue what planes were, she said. What was coming was police arriving by plane. They lined her up with the others in a flat gravel spot from where, Anthony says, they watched a bulldozer emerge from the distance and crawl toward her family's camp. This thing started plowing all our belongings, everything that we owned, she said. All their belongings were pushed into a pile and covered with gravel so we couldn't get into it again. She said, the hermit who were gathered were immediately put onto a plane without being told where they were going. According to a government report, authorities had neglected their inclusion of an interpreter to explain why they were being moved. Everyone went quiet, except for one. My brother was being difficult, because he did not want to leave the hermit land, Anthony said. Because he stood up for himself, the RCMP officer started beating him up. The hermit, unfamiliar with their travel, we are happy to get off the plane and onto firm ground. They were deposited southeast of their homeland, near New Elton Lake, just north of what is now the Manitoba-Nunavut border. Left with nothing except the clothes on their backs, we had no tea or food. Some died, she said. There was absolutely nothing, no mitts, no hats. All we had was our caribou clothing. Luckily, it was during springtime, so nobody froze to death right away. But without shelter in the cold days and nights of early spring, illness was inevitable. 2 old men, 2 old women, and 2 children all died from coughing and the flu, Anthony said. The dead were buried on a sandy slope with no traditional burial. In 1957, the hermit were forcibly relocated again. This was the second of at least 5 relocations to come to another barren location several hundred kilometers away. Unautilik was finally moved to Aviat in 1958. She received $1,000,000 as part of the $5 million settlement with the Canadian government over the forced relocations of the hermit in the 1950s. In its apology, the Canadian government acknowledged the relocation of the hermit was made without explanation, without consultation, and without consent.
Let's start with our first question. Our first question is, the news is about, now let's check out the available options. The first option is, about a woman who is very sad. Second option is, apology by the government. Third option is, a Maurice Antony who was uprooted forcibly by the government. And last fourth option is, about government. According to the audio, our third option is correct as we can listen very clearly in the audio is about a woman, a Maurice Antony who was uprooted forcibly by the government. So accordingly, our third option is the correct option. Now, let's move to the second question. Our second question is, 21 survivors of forced resettlement were gathered. Now let's check out the available options. The first option is, for the formal apology by the Canada government. Second option is, for the relocation of their homes. Third option is, for the settlement of hermits. And last fourth option is, for punishing them. According to the audio, our first option is correct as we can listen very clearly in the audio that 21 survivors of forced resettlement were gathered for the formal apology by the Canada government. So accordingly our first option is correct option. Let's see our third question. Our third question is, there were no stores, no preachers, no nurses but they live happily because, now let's check out the available options. The first option is, of teaching of elders and adults. Second option is, of food they eat. Third option is, of environment they live in. And last fourth option is, of society. According to our question, our first option is correct as we can listen very clearly that there were no stores, no preachers, no nurses but they live happily because of teaching of elders and adults. So accordingly, first option is the correct option, that is of teaching of elders and adults. Now let's move to our fourth question. Our fourth question is, all their belongings and tents were destroyed by the officials so that, now our available options are, option 1 is, they cannot remember it again, option 2 is, they can bring their relatives into it, option 3 is, they can build it again, and last option 4 is, they couldn't get into it again. We can listen very clearly in the audio that all their belongings and tents were destroyed by the officials so that they couldn't get into it again. So accordingly, option 4 is the correct option, that is they couldn't get into it again. Let's move to our last fifth question. Our fifth question is, luckily it happened during springtime so, let's check out the available options. Option 1 is, nobody froze to death right away. Option 2 is, there was cold outside. Option 3 is, there were flowers all around. And last option 4 is, there was enough food to eat. According to the audio, our first option is correct as we can listen that luckily it happened during springtime so nobody froze to death right away. So accordingly our first option is correct. So, friends, I think this tutorial will give you some idea about how to choose the right option in listening to a news item task. Please register on CellPup Store to experience the real-time based practice platform. Link to join the platform is mentioned in the below description. Don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get instant notifications. Thanks for spending time with us.